Now, last month, 579 children in two batches were detained in Palakkad in Kerala over charges of child trafficking. Now, 119 of those children have been sent back to Jharkhand, even as a question mark hangs over their future. Rohini Swami sent us this report.
This is the very train, the Ernakulam-Patna Express, that brought these young children to Kerala. At this very young age, they faced almost 2 weeks of helplessness, red tapism and separation from their loved ones. It was only after the Kerala High Court demanded some action that these children have finally boarded the train to go back home. They were brought to Kerala by men who claimed to be a part of Madarsa in Kerala, offering education and good life. Last month, 466 children were illegally transported by rail en route to orphanages in Kozhikode and Malappuram, but were taken into custody and later handed over to the Child Welfare Committee by the Railway Police. But after nearly 2 weeks of separation from their family or even sisters who accompanied them, these children were finally sent home by the Kerala government. So finally, these children with mandatory documents and affidavits from parents as well as whose parents came looking for them after media reported their arrest have been sent back to their states. Interestingly, the Chief Minister of Kerala, Oman Chandy, said that it cannot be called a case of trafficking till the investigation have been completed. But on the other hand, the Jharkhand CM called it a case of trafficking and has asked for a CBI inquiry into the incident. The Kerala State Crime Branch till now has arrested two men as they were involved in illegally transporting these children to Kerala. With Rohini Swami, Bureau Report, Headlines Today.
Joining me now is Neena Naik, former member of the National Commission for Protection of Child Rights. Ms. Neena Naik, now these children have been sent to Jharkhand, but the big question remains, what makes them travel all the way from Jharkhand and Bihar to Kerala, and what happens to their future now?
See, the education system is not functioning there. Poverty is definitely the crucial issue there. So moving children from one state to another, which you call displacement, per se you cannot say it's illegal. The children have been moved for education. But these are the most vulnerable and the most marginalized of children. So the government has to step in. The government cannot abrogate its responsibility. And if you talk about West Bengal and if you talk about Bihar, they already have their madrasa boards. These must regulate who are these children, where are these children. And government has come up with a number of schemes, like the sponsor scheme for quality education to madrasas, and then the right to education says it's compulsory that children between 6 and 14 are in school. So where are these schools for those children? I think what's really happening is that the Department of Education has not done a census of the number of children there, whether they are in school or out, and they should be held accountable. So once you know at the source, And this is not only happening with Madrasa, these are happening with children from the Northeast, etc. It's a huge, huge issue. I wouldn't say it's trafficking. It is some vested interest, definitely, because the parents, due to poverty, unable to look after their children, are craving for quality education for their children, and so are enticed by these people to send them to different places. And at the madrasas where they arrive, there's an ample opportunity for these people to raise funds once the children are physically there.
Right. Thanks a lot, Ms. Nina Naik, for that perspective. In fact, the Jharkhand Chief Minister has said that it is a case of child trafficking. That's it then on this edition of Up South this Tuesday evening. News and updates continue on the other side on Headlines Today.